Alright, the camera is done and... Oh shit! Hi, what's up guys? Welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you my awesome build, but still not there because... So here are the parts I'm using for this build.
So right here, we have our ASRock B450 Pro 4 motherboard. This board can support AMD and only used for Ryzen CPUs. Next, over here we have two 8GB RAM sticks that is branded Patriot. Next, over here we have Superflower 750W as our power supply. Next, we have our CPU cooler. This is kind of the special AMD cooler we have here, because this is supposedly for the Ryzen 7 build. For our CPU fan, we are using the Arc Spectrum F1 starter kit. Yeah, if let's say you are building a computer with RGB lights, this would be the one to go. So next up, we have here, this is left by my good friends, two SSD. One is Samsung 970 EVO 500GB and one 860 250GB. Yeah, two SSD. Sure. Lastly, we have our AMD Ryzen CPU, Ryzen 3 2200G. This graphics card has Vega graphics in it. And next up, we have our S340 Mid Tower NZXT chassis.
So now, here's the part you guys are waiting for, the building part.
So over here we have our motherboard and two SSDs. So we're gonna put it inside the SSD slot, the first one, the M.2 screw. Put it like that and screw it in. Okay, you don't have to screw it very tight, just make sure it's according to that position, then you'll be okay. So the next one, slide it in at 45 degrees and take your screws, your screwdriver, and just screw it in. And also be careful when you screw the screws in, sometimes the screws are small and it drops off. And here you go. Right now, we're gonna add in our RAM sticks. So opening the second and the fourth lane because of the priority wise. So just have to look out for the edge of the RAM and fitting it into the motherboard, the channel lane. Clicking in, there will be two clicks. Know that you really secure the RAM seat. Just like this, two clicks, and you are done. Next up, we will be adding our CPU in. So right here, this will be different from other motherboards because this is a AMD Ryzen build, of course. So taking your AMD CPU, below are golden pins. So you just have to fit it in onto the motherboard where it will land really right. Yeah, just like that. Okay. So how to know if you put it at the right way? There's a mini golden triangle at the bottom left. So that's right. You will just fit in the way if you put it correctly. And just bring the lever down, secure it in place, wiggle it a little, make sure you won't move and the lever doesn't come up, and you're done. Next up, we have our CPU cooler, which has two latch at the sides to be secured onto the AMD CPU. Next up, we will be taking the thermal paste and putting it on the CPU. People always like to put a small grain, but I always like to just put one grain and just draw a circle. Yeah, just like that, and you're good to go. Inserting the thermal paste, hooking the CPU cooler latch on one side and two. Okay, then just adjust it a little, so make sure it can fit in. And right about, once you're done, you can press down. And yeah, just like that. You're locked in position and just press it down. You have a hard force, down with great strength and carry it up. You'll make sure to secure it and you're done. Next up, once you put in your CPU cooler, you'll take your CPU wire and route it to your nearest CPU fan, the plug. And what I like to do is always coil the wire onto each other. But where you have to tighten it, so you will have like a coil kind of loop, I don't know how to say it. Then after that, you just plug it in your nearest CPU fan slot. Once it's just a little, make sure it's plugged in. Yeah. Once that is done, I'll turn that. Then once you're done, put the wire in under the CPU fan and you're done. So now we'll be taking our Spectra fan. Reason being, when we take our case, we're gonna change the fans in there first to these fans right here. Also, how can we forget our IO shield? Let's take off the front and back panels. So firstly, you take your IO shield and put it in this position. After that, this will be the part where you unscrew all the fans and replacing it with the Spectra fan. Letting you guys know, placing of the fan is very important. It's because the fan outblowing direction is very important, as you want to have the case circulate the air properly. Done adding the Spectra fan, slot in your motherboard and start screwing it onto the chassis. Also, be careful to always use your screwdrivers to screw the screws into the motherboard, because using drill you might break the white small like soldering dots on the motherboard, which is not very good lah, from what the person who taught me how to build computer said. So once you're done installing the motherboard, the remaining wires at the back are the chassis wire, so you have to go route it to the motherboard. And to my room for the next part.
So now you're in my room, alright? So next up, we're gonna need some cable ties, some cable cutters. Yeah, we're gonna route some wires. So to the tying part.
First off, the F panel wires, the USB wires, and lastly, the HD audio wire. So now, I will be showing you where to put the wires at. For the F panel wires, this one. Insert it in the motherboard at the bottom right, at this orderly manner right here. For the HD audio wire, this one is to be inserted right here at the bottom left of the motherboard. Next, we have our USB wire, which needs to be inserted here, slotting the wire's header shape on the motherboard's USB header shape accordingly. Let cable tie all the wires nicely. So next, we'll be taking out the cage of the chassis to put in our power supply. Not all cases needs to do this, so always measure if it's possible to fit in the power supply before trying to force it in. After that, take the hexagon screws to screw in the power supply to secure it in place. Next, we have the SATA cable. Our 24-pin, 2 GPU power cable for our graphics card, then our 4-pin connector, and next our CPU cable. For the CPU cable, we'll be plugging it in here. For the 24-pin, we'll be connecting it here. Without a hard disk and my GPU yet to come, this is what to expect. After that, with the remaining wires, I tie it up with zip ties and also doing some cable management along the way. So cable management is very important, as coiling up wires and find space to slot them is very crucial, as without a good cable management, airflow won't be smooth too, right? Lastly, for our rainbow lights to appear, we need the hub where we'll be connecting our wires in the hub. Also, I forgot to mention to use the 4-pin connector to connect to our Tesla fan hub. And here comes the most exciting part we are all waiting for. Plug in the power supply and press the power button and there you go. Here's your complete build.
After you finish your build, you will have to put it somewhere you find it looks nice. So I have a few adjustments here and there while putting in my room because my table is quite small. So you can look at my designs that I have so called put it on the table.